I'm Janice Edwards. Tangled is the latest Disney movie, and it stars Mandy Moore and Zachary Levi as Rapunzel and Flynn Rider.
We actually didn't get to work together at all on this film.
I thought you'd say that, yes.
We did our dialogue session separately, but there really was no point of reference. I guess maybe that's the way of doing an animated film. It's not like you have the film finished and you're able to sort of look at your character and their movements and physicality and whatnot. So it really takes a lot of imagination and sort of like digging deep, since you are by yourself, to just sort of, I don't know, try whatever your instincts are telling you to do. But in that sense, it's also a lot of fun, too. It kind of feels like being a kid again. You can embarrass yourself and not worry about the repercussions, I guess, because no one's there.
How was it for you, Zachary?
I think it's a really fun way to use your imagination. And unfortunately, the older you get, the less of your imagination you employ in life, I think. Though it was kind of a bummer that we didn't get to do dialogue together, right. I can understand. Logistically, it's very difficult scheduling and getting people together. It's a long, you know, and it takes over a year to do all the recording. They're constantly zhuzhing and moving things and, you know, fine-tuning and... Which is also, you know, it gives me a lot of confidence in the film, knowing that John Lasseter and the gang are all, you know, looking at it on every level. And if something's not working, we'll re-record it and re-record it and re-record it. Sometimes there were sequences, I'd come in, you know, sequence 14 or whatever, I don't know what it was, and we recorded, and I'd felt, okay, great, that felt great, really got it. And then I'd come 6 weeks later, I'd come back in, and it's sequence 14 again. I'm like,
what happened here?
What did I do wrong? And I'm like, no, it wasn't you. It wasn't you. It was Mandy. Yeah, there you go.
It's all your fault, Mandy.
Always,
yeah, right.
Always.
So it's, you know, it's. I wouldn't necessarily call it painstaking, because I don't necessarily think it's difficult. And you know, it's fun. It's a lot. It's really fun work to do.
Yeah.
But different than doing live action, you know, good and bad. I mean, there's no hair and makeup and wardrobe, so that's a lot of fun.
Right. That's the easy part of it.
Yeah. But you don't also, you know, you don't have someone to work off of. But again, imagination, all that, you know, interesting and excellent process.
Yes, and when you see the finished product, you're amazed, I'm sure, to see that as well,
having done all of this.
You know, one of the things I know that both of you give back to the world and the communities, and because we're kind of short on time, I'd like to ask you about your trip to South Sudan as the ambassador for PSA 5 and Alive. How did that impact your life?
Oh, gosh, it definitely sort of puts everything into perspective really quick. It's incredible to think that, wow, because of what I get to do, it sort of gives me this odd platform then to raise awareness about different causes. And I got to go and see a lot of the work that PSI and all of their partners on the ground, whether it's the UN Foundation or UNICEF or the Global Fund, different water programs that they've implemented. And I'm the ambassador for their child survival program. So it's kids 5 and under in the developing world. And it's amazing. I just got back from the Central African Republic on this massive net distribution with the UN Foundation, and it was, again, just mind-boggling, so unbelievably life-changing.
It's amazing how you're doing that in addition to the work that you're doing and music and being newly married. And I know, Zachary, you also like to give back. So why is it important for you to make those contributions in addition to the work that you do as an artist?
Oh, well, I don't know. I mean, I think the world is a really beautiful and amazing place, but it's also, you know, it's harsh, and I think we have to accept the reality of it, which is that some of us are very, very blessed. We're very blessed to get to do what we do, and I think seems kind of trite to quote Spider-Man, but with great power comes great responsibility, and I think when you're given the opportunity that we have and the resources that we have, it is our responsibility to wield that and utilize that for as much good as you can get out of it. We're given these platforms, whether we like it or not. Mm-hmm. And you can either use that platform to be selfish and self-serving, or you can use that platform to really make a difference in people's lives. And I mean, and there's nothing more rewarding. I love being able to do what I do, but to be able to put all that aside and say, okay, great, I've got your ear, whether it be through Facebook or Twitter or what have you, and say, let's go change lives. Let's go actually do something that means something to somebody other than ourselves. That's incredible, you know.
It is incredible.
And I know that will last beyond whenever I'm gone from this planet.
I think you said it right there. It definitely is sort of a coming of age story in a sense for both of them. There's a lot of self-discovery and self-revelation that I don't think neither one sort of expects when they first venture out. I love that at the end of the day, Rapunzel, a character who's lived 18 years in this tower with 70 feet of long magical hair, she's been told her whole life that that's what makes her special, is this magical hair of hers. But, you know, she comes to find out that it's something that's been within her all along. And perhaps that's obvious, perhaps it's a cliche, but I kind of don't think there's really no more important message than that, you know?
How about you for Flynn? Well,
I mean, I think Flynn's journey is a little bit different, but it's the same in how it kind of progresses. I mean, he's one person.